I think your relationship with money is really interesting in your 20s because it's like the first time you're actually getting a disposable income. Maybe you're getting your first real job, not just one you had as a teenager, and all those things that you wanted, you can finally start to have. I believe your 20s is a time to get those things that you've always wanted because in my experience, once I finally had them, I stopped wanting more. So let me explain. Money. Number one on the list of best purchases is my car that I currently have right now. My car is a 2017 Audi A4. It's a 3-year lease and I pay about $600 a month. So how is this a good purchase? I know this one sounds weird because a car is literally the worst purchase you could make. Once you drive it off the lot, it loses a bunch of value. It's just a money suck. You're not gaining anything financially from it. But what I've gained from this is like finally a feeling of satisfaction and no longer like wanting and wanting. I always thought cars were so cool and I knew I always wanted an Audi since I was like 12 years old. And so I would fixate on it. Every time I got in my car, I just wouldn't like it and I would see other cars on the road and I'd wish that I had them. And I always just wished and wished and wished that I had that nicer car, that car I always dreamed of. I was seriously obsessed. I would look online all the time. It was like a huge waste of time. I am very lucky that I did get to the point where I was able to get my dream car. That doesn't always happen, but let me tell you, I'm happy that I have gotten this car because I finally feel satisfied to the point where I just feel like I have it out of my system. So my car is actually a 3-year lease, and at the end of the lease in July, I don't even know if I'm gonna get another Audi because now that I've had it, I feel satisfied and it's cool, but it's not everything, and I don't like wish and wish and wish I had it anymore. Like, I still love it, but I know I could live without it and be just as happy with another car. And that's something that I think is really important. I really got that out of my system. I don't waste my time like wishing that I had like this thing anymore. Basically, I love my car and I've never regretted it, but I think I will be saying goodbye to it because I have bigger things that I want to invest my money in, like saving for a down payment on a home. This is the first ever luxury bag that I got. And once again, this was an item, especially as a girl, that I just fixated on. I wanted the nice bag that all the other girls had.
This bag is the Givenchy Antigona. I bought it for $1,750 at Bergdorf Goodman, and it's about 4 years old.
Before this bag, I always noticed the other bags that girls had. Maybe I was a bit materialistic, yes, but I always noticed, and if someone had like a cool designer bag, I'd be like, oh my God, that's so cool. Like, I want one. Like, they're cool. Once I finally got this bag, I was excited. I really like it, but I just fully stopped caring about designer stuff after I got it. I was like, okay, cool. I have this. I'm happy. I'm satisfied. I just like didn't care at all. And I didn't care if people had cheaper bags. I don't know. I just kind of stopped caring about designer stuff. So I have to bring up the fact that I did get this bag recently. I love this bag. The reason I got this bag is because I was doing a branded integration with the company, The Real Real. So they gave me obviously like a deal on the bag and it was cool. Like, I appreciate designer things, but after getting my first designer thing, I'm not someone that just wants and wants and wants and like needs to have it and thinks about it. It's just not really something that I think about anymore. I hope this makes sense. Like, before I had the bag, I fixated on it and I spent my energy thinking about how I wanted this thing. And then I finally got it and I'm happy that I have it and I no longer fixate or spend energy wanting that sort of thing. So that's why I'm happy with this purchase, because once again, it's something that I got out of my system. This isn't to say I won't get a nice car or bag in the future, but it's just not really something I waste my energy thinking about anymore. Whereas when I was younger, I definitely did. My next best purchase was my college education. It was pretty much a known thing that I was gonna have to figure out how to pay for my college by myself, which is how it is for a lot of kids, obviously. So I didn't fully finish college, but I did take college classes, and I am so happy with how I did it and the money that I did spend on it, because I feel like the classes that I took really did teach me real life skills that I need to apply to my life. I decided to go to the school Orange Coast College in Orange County, California. OCC, as I called it, was a community college, so the classes were a lot cheaper and they were known for having good film classes, which was my interest. So basically, I just applied to the school, and because it's a community college, I got in like the next day, right? Like, whatever. And I picked the classes that I wanted to take. I think I took three classes each each semester and I took 3 semesters, so I took 9 classes total. Out of state, that was $1,000 a class, and I think in state you pay like $300 a class. It was very, very affordable. So at this time I was like 18 years old and I was making some YouTube money, but like I wasn't like rolling in the dough. But taking those 3 classes for $1,000 each, I was able to pay my own way the $3,000 each semester, and I didn't have to go into debt because it was only $3,000 versus like $10,000, $20,000, $30,000, you know, all those crazy prices for college. I loved the classes that I took. I learned so much from them. Like, I wouldn't be where I am today without those classes. They taught me more about the theory of filmmaking and storytelling, as well as the technical production side. It totally changed my perspective on YouTube. The teachers were so helpful and supportive, and I loved it there. Shout out to Orange Coast College. The one thing that I didn't get was like industry connections, which is, you know, you'd get that if you went to like USC. The bigger name schools do make it easier to like get that good internship or whatever, but you can go to Orange Coast College and become a good filmmaker. And I'm so happy I went there. I'm happy I spent my money there versus my dream school was Chapman, which is like $50,000 a year. If I would have gotten in, I'd be $200,000 in debt. Are you kidding me? My next best purchase was my camera. I use this thing every day. It's a part of my business. It was just investing in my business. So it's a very smart purchase. But I have a little story to go along with why this was such a good purchase. So I have the Panasonic Lumix GH5. Most people have Canon or Sony, and I have a Panasonic, and I love my Panasonic so much. So I got this camera 2 summers ago, and it was when I was moving back to Seattle. And I used to live in LA with Shelby, and we shared all the same equipment. So when I decided that I wanted to move back, she was like, well, I'm keeping the nice camera that we use, which was the Canon 5D Mark IV. And I was like, okay, that's fair. I'll go back and I'll probably just go get one of those. And I was thinking about it and I was like, you know, I don't want to buy like the same camera I already had. It's just like annoying to rebuy the same thing you had. It's just not fun. And I've always only had Canon. At that point, I'd probably been making videos for like 6 years and I'd only used Canon cameras and that was it. And I was like, what if there's something better out there? I didn't want to switch because I was afraid of having to like go over the hump of the learning curve that is a new camera. It has different switches for things and different strengths and weaknesses. And I was genuinely like afraid to do that. But I was like, you know what if there is something better out there and you're never gonna know and you're never gonna grow as a filmmaker or as a YouTuber if you don't go out and try something new. So I marched myself into the camera store nearest me, which is Glazer's Camera in Seattle. I really like that store. I went in there and I was like, I want a Sony camera because Sony is like the hot camera everyone has. I feel like everyone has a Sony and thinks the Sony is like so amazing. Thank God the guy working there was like, why do you want a Sony? And I was like, because I make videos and it does good video stuff and I had the 5D Mark IV and I just don't want that anymore. And he was like, no, you don't want the Sony. You want the GH5. And I was like, no, I think I want the Sony. I think I know what I want. And he was like, no, seriously, like go to the rental house next door and just try it out for a day. And if you like it, when you come back and buy it, that rental cost goes into the price of your purchase. So I was like, okay, yeah, I'll go rent it. But it's a big purchase, so you wanna know you're getting, you know, the right thing for you. So I rented it, I tried it out, and it was incredible. I started to learn how it's such a better camera. It has all of these amazing settings that the Canon didn't have. It very clearly, once I got that camera, made me a better videographer. It's insane, and I love this camera. I use it every single day of my life, but I'm just really happy I wasn't afraid to finally just try something new out. My fifth best purchase is my orthodontic treatment that I've had. Finally deciding to go to an orthodontist can be like a really big decision because it can be expensive, but with what I do, being on camera all the time, editing my face for hours and hours on end, oh, trust me, I know every square millimeter of my face and every single flaw, and it eats me up. And one thing I was insecure about was my teeth. I hate how my teeth look. I still don't like how this side looks. But I still have a couple months of Invisalign to go. So I've been seeing an orthodontist for over a year now, and I'll show you some videos looking back. My teeth looked so much worse, and now like they're looking pretty good, right? Like they've really transformed a lot. They're not finished yet, but I really actually feel so confident. I used to not like smiling in photos. Cosmetic things that make you feel more confident are very important because they directly link to your happiness, okay? And when you're confident, you're more successful in all aspects of life, in your job, in your relationships, everything. everything. So it was a no-brainer that this is one of my best purchases because it makes me feel more confident and more happy. And that's a really big deal. My number six best purchase is some of my new room furniture. If you guys saw, I recently put up a room tour. I'll have it linked below if you want to check it out. And there are a few really big pieces that I bought, like the dresser and the nightstands. And I find them to be really good purchases because they're high quality pieces of furniture and they're really gonna last. And I knew buying them, I wanted to invest in something that I was gonna have for a really long time versus just going to IKEA and getting, you know, the same old stuff that like starts to break after a couple years. And IKEA is great and there's a time and a place, but I was like, you know what? I'm at a point in my life where I want to upgrade. And that's something also my parents kind of taught me. They buy better quality furniture because it lasts. And I think because that's something my parents do, it's something that I knew I wanted to do as well. So I really value high quality furniture. And my number seven best purchase is really just anything having to do with travel. I never regret a trip where I go and travel somewhere because it's an experience and life is literally about experiencing things. So those are the best purchases that I've made in my 20s. Overall, I'm feeling a lot more satisfied. I would say a big trend within these purchases are I've started to purchase more quality things that are gonna be long lasting, or I don't regret something that's an experience because it creates a memory that's worth living for. I don't regret things that make me happy or make me feel more confident. I don't regret things that make you smarter, and I don't regret some of the materialistic things that actually just like finally filled that void and left me satisfied and no longer wanting more. So I hope you guys like this video. Let me know in the comments your best purchases in your 20s. I really would love to know. And if you wanna watch my video on my dumbest purchases, I'll have that linked below too, because that's the real tea on the dumb purchases I've made. If you're new to my channel, be sure to subscribe and follow me on Instagram and check out my vlogs. Really, just everything will be down below. So just stay on my channel, keep watching my videos, okay?